Happy holidays, guys. It is that time of year again, and what better place to be than in San Bernardino? We have so many nonprofits, so many amazing businesses that are really celebrating the holidays and supporting our local community. I can't wait for you to find out more information here on Inland Empire Live. I'm Betsy. Thanks for joining. Welcome to Inland Empire Live. I am so excited to introduce you to our next guest. You have known the business, Brew Rebellion, but I don't think you guys have met these crazy guys yet, and I'm excited to introduce you. We've got Brad, and we've got Ed Parker.
Yes.
You guys are the big honchos of Brew Rebellion.
Oh, yeah, we're it.
We have amazing power.
Yeah. So we did have some of your guys from Brew Rebellion come last time, but since then.
The B team.
Is that, so we have the A team now.
Right, there you go.
But since then, you guys have grown in such a really incredible way. So maybe we can just reflect for a quick second since we've got these the big wigs here today and tell us how it started and then how you guys have grown.
Well, we had a very detailed plan, financing plan to get started. 3 years ago, we actually went to the swap meet, and we sold sports cards and even a massage table, didn't there?
Your old war equipment from World War I?
So it sounds like some random cool stuff.
Right, and
we had all of that, and we just sold this stuff. And over 5 weekends, we raised $3,500. And then we went and we leased a small building behind a Mexican market in Yucaipa.
Mm-hmm.
Which is still there, and that's our first location. And it's a little hard to find, but once you get there, you never forget it. So then we started there, and then we had an opportunity. The city manager from San Bernardino came over, and he says, why don't you open up a brewery in San Bernardino?
Why not?
And I go, it makes sense to us. And we were, at that time, we were looking into doing something with the city of Moreno Valley, and it just didn't work. And so we came over here, and we were fortunate enough to be able to find a good building. The San Bernardino Airport Authority had been very, very helpful to us, and we got a great location. So now we have two locations going.
A fantastic location in the heart of San Bernardino.
Oh, it is, yeah.
And that is just absolutely fantastic. I mean, we have our own brewery now. I love this.
That's right.
You know,
the money is going to stay here instead of going out to...
Yeah, absolutely.
Because Redlands has 5 breweries.
Mm-hmm. You know, I was going to say, it's actually a pretty competitive market.
So we are the first and only brewery in San Bernardino.
You guys hear that? First and only. We got to support them.
There you go.
So it's really interesting when you were saying you went to the swap meet and started selling off just kind of random cool stuff. It kind of makes me think of your beer selection. Like, I just absolutely love that you guys have continued to grow, but a big part of your goal is to still stay small as well so you guys can have flexibility in what you brew and how you brew it. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Well, leave the brewing to Brad.
Well, we change beers all the time. We've probably done over 200 since we first...
200? 200
sure.
Different kinds of beers.
Yeah, I think we have around 40 or so in bottles for label approval already. And then we're constantly, we have about 10 or 12 honey wheat recipes alone. Blueberry, raspberry, strawberry, pineapple.
Where are these recipes coming from? Just like whatever's in your fridge?
How
does that work?
No, Andy and I like will talk about something and we'll do like a peach honey wheat, for instance. And then
oh, that sounds delicious.
In the summer, watermelon makes sense or whatever is coming out when raspberries come out. And then peppers will come out and we'll say, let's add habanero to the raspberry honey wheat. And then the things just kind of progress.
And half of our beers are geared for a female palate, too.
Interesting. Why is that?
Well, because I've been married for 43 years and I realized
good job. Congratulations.
I don't go anywhere that Mrs. Parker doesn't want to go. It's that simple. So, and we believe that women are an underserved market in the craft beer market. Everybody wants nasty, gnarly beers for a bunch of guys to sit around and, you know, but Women, guys go where women are, not the other
well,
way around.
But guys want to have flavor in their beer too. Yeah. We make stouts with cinnamon and chocolate and coconut and pumpkin. And you don't want to drink the same beer every single day at weddings and funerals and birthdays. You want to drink summer beers and winter beers and sometimes different beers throughout the evening. So
it's holidays. You mentioned winter beers. We are approaching the holidays. Let's talk about the flavors.
Well, we've
already
done some pumpkin mm-hmm. beers. We have a pumpkin latte, chocolate pumpkin pie. We did a s'more porter with pumpkin last year.
Yeah, I think you guys brought that one the last time, and it was incredible.
Yeah. We'll have Earth available.
That's Earth,
it's a winter warmer made with hazelnut, cinnamon, nutmeg, allspice.
Oh, wow.
And a little magic
roasted
dust.
Roasted chestnuts.
And some magic dust.
Chestnuts. then a s'more porter we do with chocolate, graham cracker, marshmallows, and we do a cranberry winter ale.
Ned, is it possible that you guys have a favorite? I can imagine it changes
no
a
favorites.
Lot.
No favorites. It's just like children.
We did
like some of them at a certain point in time, but you can't call a favorite.
We did have an interesting thing happen. A lady in British Columbia got a bottle of our pumpkin ale, the chocolate pumpkin pie. And so she sent me an email, and she says, I had your pumpkin pie ale, and it was awesome. She says, I'm going to send you an article I'm going to write on it. And I thought, well, that's pretty nice, you know. Mm-hmm. Turns out she was a travel column writer for the San Francisco Chronicle. So she listed our little brewery in Yucaipa as one of the five places to visit and over the Christmas and Thanksgiving mm-hmm. season in all of California.
Wow.
And it was really neat. And we have people still show up and go, hey, I saw
and
you
ask
an
for
article.
That beer, which is not available.
Yeah.
Not available all the time. But it's just funny how it has its own life.
Yeah.
Know?
Well, and I would say, I mean, you just kind of underplay it with, it was really neat when it was, like, your hard work is paying off. And I love that when you guys were starting off, not only were you selling at the swap meet, you were selling memberships in the beginning, right? Tell us about those, because that's evolved for holidays,
that
too.
That was all Brad right there.
It took about 3.5 years to sell 100 founder memberships to help get the brewery started. Andy and I thought maybe 25,000 would do it. And that clearly wasn't enough. but we sold these memberships, 100 of them, for $250 a piece. Mm-hmm. And it got people 10% off beers, invitation to special events, chances to try and buy beers. And it was so popular, after we opened up the Rebel Club. And now that's $150 a year. You get a buck off every beer. You drink half price on Monday, so that's very popular too.
I was going to say, you need to mark your calendars for Mondays.
Well, we're open Thursday through Monday.
Yeah.
In San Bernardino and in Yucaipa. And we got a hot dog guy there every once in a while, Friday, Saturday nights.
And we got to do a pitch hot dogs. For him, that his name is, his business is One Dog or Two.
And he does craft hot dogs too. So he'll he'll do a peanut butter and raspberry jelly hot dog match with our peanut butter and raspberry
really creative
beer.
With that. We have
that is so cool. So clearly a perfect partnership between
very
you
good,
guys.
Yes.
Now, if you could give us a little insight as to, besides just being in San Bernardino and being the first brewery, why is this particular location so special to you?
You know, I'm so old. I came home from Vietnam in the Marine Corps and landed out at this airport at Norton Air Force Base then.
Wow. You were coming home.
Yes, when I came home, and I had no idea where I was. And it kind of struck me when we made the deal on this building. Mm-hmm. I go, I'm like 200 feet from where I landed. And so it's like full circle.
Yeah.
The other thing is that people don't respect San Bernardino. We have had a lot of people really give us a bad time. Why are you going there? They just don't understand. This is a great town. This is a great potential town. And
the National
really,
Orange Show was huge when I was a kid. My dad was a service manager at Inland Center Dodge.
Yes.
This place was really big. Mm-hmm. The Red Rocker came from here. There was great concerts here all the time in the 80s.
Yeah.
We want to give people in our local area.
We had two malls, Central
here.
City and Inland Empire, right next to each other. It was thriving.
We'd like them to have a place where people could come and spend time with each other and relax and maybe watch a game or something like
that. And people are really excited.
And they're really,
we've had a lot of...
There hasn't been places that people can do that in San Bernardino, really.
Yeah.
And it's growing more and more, and it takes some foundational people like yourselves that believe and respect and just love the city and know what it's been and what it can absolutely be.
And we have great support from the firemen, the police department, the airport people, the city managers have all been in there.
Alan Parker has been a big, big supporter.
So everybody's really behind it and really wants it to
Everybody's behind it, guys. Like, if you weren't convinced already that it's an amazing small business. Yeah, say hi. Everybody's watching you. If you weren't convinced already, this is a phenomenal business to support because they're supporting you and your community. I love having you guys here. I can't wait till you come back and tell us about your next location and your next, and I'm going to have to buy one of those memberships for
the
holidays. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Brad. Crazy Brad. And you guys are the best.
Why does everybody
and
say
we will
that?
Be right back, everybody.
Thank you.